Hi there and welcome back to Calculus of Variations. In this little snippet I'm going to look at the second order total differential. Now from the last video we looked at a function, write it down again, z is some function of x and y, and we looked at the total differential dz equals partial f by partial x times dx plus partial f by partial y times dy. Now I derived that and I showed a little thought experiment so you could picture exactly what each of these terms were. Now in this video we're going to differentiate again and we're going to find the second order total differential. So we're going to say we're looking for d by dz. Okay, now we use the same process we did here. So we in effect iterate this process. We know that dz will change with respect to the x coordinate and dz will change with respect to the y coordinate. So we're going to have a partial by partial x where y is held constant, okay, of something, okay, and we know times dx, okay, same way we did up here, and I'll write the second one down here because I've got enough room, plus partial by partial y of something times dy. So we've just done the same thing here as we did here. Okay, the only difference is that this equation here now becomes the whole equation getting placed in here. So it's going to be partial f by partial x of dx plus partial f by partial y of dy, and again partial f by, oh, I'll try to keep that right and neat, partial x dx plus partial f by partial y dy. The problem is my brain runs in front of my hand and I try to write too fast and it ends up a bit of a mess, so I have to try and keep myself slow my hand, my brain down a little bit. Because I can't speed up my hand, it just makes a mess. Right, so we've got this partial derivative here and this one here. Now that is a function, that is a multiplication of two functions. One function's partial f by partial x, the other one's dx. So we can use the product rule for differentiation. So that one term there will create two terms, that one term there will create two terms, and the same with that one, the same with that one. So we're going to end up with 2, 4, 6, 8 terms. Now eventually four of those terms will disappear and two of them will get amalgamated and we'll only actually have three terms in the end. But what we'll do is we'll just go through the longhand so you at least see it once. Okay, so let's do this one first. So you're going to have, if we differentiate this first and then multiply by that, you're going to have partial squared f by partial x squared times dx plus, and we differentiate that, multiply by this, you're going to have partial dx upon partial x times partial f by partial x. Okay, so that's two of the terms coming from here, right? Plus, now we'll do this one here, so you're going to have partial f by partial x partial y, so partial squared f upon partial x partial y times dy plus, and we'll differentiate that one, so we'll be partial dy by dx partial x, sorry, times partial f by partial y, partial f by partial y. So all we've done is just apply the product rule for these two terms and we get four terms. Now we'll do the same for this lot here and we'll get another four terms, so we'll just, let's get through it and get it done. So we'll have partial squared f by partial y partial x times dx plus partial dx by partial y times partial f by partial x. Okay, so that's us done this and split it into two. Now the final one here is going to be partial squared f upon partial y squared times dy, okay, plus, and the final one is partial dy by partial y times partial f by partial y. Now you know as well that these two are multiplied by dx, okay, so these two just to are multiplied by dx. Okay, there's the dx there, the dx is multiplying the product of these, okay, so all of this is getting multiplied by dx. So although I kind of squeeze it in there, but it's all getting multiplied by dx, okay, so I'll put dx at the front there. Actually, can you see it? Actually, there's dx at the front there, okay, and again all of that there is getting multiplied by our dy there. Okay, bit of a mess there at the end, but okay, so those are our eight terms. Now we're going to simplify this and get it down into something reasonable. Now the way to simplify it is that to note that this term here, dx, well, dx is an infinitesimal, it's just a distance, okay, so it's a constant, just a number, a constant. So when you differentiate a constant, you get zero. So that there, that term there, will give you zero because that's just a constant. Okay? There. There. Remember, dx, if you go back to our simple example, would be the distance along the x-axis, or the dy, the distance along the y-axis that you're multiplying your differential by. So it's just a constant. So that disappears. By the same value, that dy is just a constant, it disappears. Okay, dx again disappears, dy again disappears. Okay, so now you're only left with four values. So I'll take the first section here and I'll write it in a simplified form. So that would be written as f x x, meaning you differentiate with respect to x and then again with respect to x, multiply by dx, and remember this dx here as well, so it's going to be dx, yeah, squared. Okay, now the last term as well over here, so that's that little term done. The last term over here, again it's going to be f y y, differentiate with y and then y again, of, and then your dy times your dy there, so you're going to have dy squared. Now the two terms in the middle are the mixed partial derivatives. Now if these mixed partial derivatives are continuous functions, then this partial x partial y will be the same as partial y partial x. They're not always the same because sometimes there are instances when they aren't continuous, but if we assume for this our purposes here that they are continuous, then this function here, this differential here equals this differential here. So we'll just pick one of them. So if we pick out plus, we call that f x y, differentiate with respect to x and respect to y, and you would have your dx times dy. So we're going to have, that's it, dy, or should I put x first just to keep it consistent. I think I can go take that off, right, so I'll just put in dx dy. Okay, so that there, if I look at here, I've got everything right there, so that's dx dy, and that's dx dy, yeah, okay, so that's everything. So that there is our total differential, which is, with that hook in there, that will be d squared z. Okay, so that's the equation that we're looking for. Okay, now we don't ever have to remember this derivation, but if we went through it once and you can see where it comes from, then this equation here will be used in the course in calculus of variations. Okay, thanks for listening and goodbye.